We got the hits. We got the gist. This is Lagos' number one lifestyle station. City 1051 FM.
Krizbeat with Amina on City 1051. I told you earlier on the show I'm going to have Krizbeat with me. All you have to do to join the conversation is leave a message on social media at City 1051. You can also call in 0700-1051-1051. That is the number to call. Krizbeat is already here. How are you doing, Krizbeat?
I'm good. What's good? How you doing?
I'm fine. I'm fantastic. How are you doing?
Great.
Okay, so you just dropped a song titled Amina.
Yes, sir. Yes, ma'am.
You featured Ricardo Banks and Rayvanny.
Rayvanny, yeah.
Okay, so why did you choose the both of them? Why?
Sorry, do you like the way my voice is sounding? I'm trying to tweak it.
Why are you tweaking it? It doesn't sound sexy.
Yeah, it was good.
No, don't. It's not working.
Yeah, it was good.
That's the new one. Why did you choose Ricardo Banks and Rayvanny?
Okay, Ricardo Banks, to start with Ricardo Banks. Ricardo Banks is like one of the guys that, you know, when I say I want to do sound that anybody can do, you know, doesn't necessarily have to be like this type of sound and I will eat it properly. Mm-hmm. So yeah, that was why I went for Ricardo Banks. And for Rayvanny, he's sick with the melody when it comes to, you know, mm-hmm. creating.
Oh, you don't. You said melody, that's my name, so I'm just running.
So he's sick with the melody.
I don't know about that though. I don't know, I can't tell.
So yeah, that's why we felt like the combination of the two of them would be crazy.
Okay. So since you dropped the song, how's the reception been?
It's been crazy. But you know, the shadows of the artist has been delaying, you know.
The video.
Oh,
okay. Yeah, so Ricardo Banks is in Nigeria, and it's not like,
yeah, you know, it's not easy to like get Ricardo. Okay, like for
Ricardo
now.
Ricardo Banks is here.
For now.
What is he doing?
For now, I have a song with Wiz and somebody.
Wiz, okay, I get
Wiz.
Do
you understand? So
Ricardo Banks,
and do you know Rayvanny?
I know Rayvanny.
Yeah, so it's
Rayvanny's in Nigeria.
Yeah, yeah, it's hard to line them up. When this one is ready, this one is not ready. So like, at the end of the day, we might have to like go here. Shoot this person.
I think you can bring Rayvanny to Nigeria, and
he came to Nigeria for the recording.
Yeah,
we didn't have to send it. He came to Nigeria.
So you can also have him come here for the video.
Yeah, let's see how it works out.
Let's see how
do you
works
shoot
out
videos?
You want to employ me? Do you want to employ me? I can shoot video. I can start with you.
I mean, show us something you don't.
Okay, so before I leave the song Amina, let me ask you more questions. Why Amina? Now, you chose that name. I don't necessarily think I've heard any Nigerian artist sing with Amina. We have quite a number of popular names that they use for your songs.
Oh, me. I have.
I've not asked you the question.
Okay.
I've not asked you the question. Calm down. So, Amina, most times or usually when Nigerian artists or when artists sing generally, they're talking about something happening in their life.
Okay.
From a personal angle, also they saw this girl at the club, okay. And you know, I saw her and I can't get over her and everything.
Okay.
So you chose Amina, not Jessica, or one very popular name that we hear regularly. Do you have anyone in your life? Oh my god, do you like? Let me just ask for asking. Is there an Amina that inspired that song?
No Amina, to be honest.
Mm.
Like, okay, there would have been an Amina, but the Amina just, you know, something just happened to the Amina history. So,
oh, you actually met an Amina.
No,
okay.
I'm just saying, like,
okay.
in the sense that, in the context that you were talking about.
Okay.
So, what inspired the song? I've always loved like all this Arab, this thing.
Fulani
so,
babes.
Yeah, Fulani.
They're
babes.
So pretty.
So yeah, and
I can
I'm
hook
so,
you up with one.
And I'm so cute, so we can. It's something.
Not that cute, but it's fine. I've got really fine Fulani girls. Like, are you single? Do you want to mingle with an Amina? Should I get you an Amina?
I would have said yes, but
you know what?
I don't want to put anybody's daughter in trouble.
Why? You're trouble. You know you're trouble, Abby.
Yeah, you know, I can be.
You can be.
I can be.
You can be. You're intentional about being. Okay. So, as producer in Nigeria, we constantly hear people complaining about producers not getting the recognition that they deserve, how they're not very appreciated in the industry. Why do you think that is?
Okay, then they don't used to get like the stuff, the accolades that they deserve.
Yeah.
But now I think it's changing because
mm-hmm.
we have different people. You have people like me, you
mm-hmm.
know, coming
drama boy
and telling you that, oh yeah, you could you could be a producer, you could be a producer and get your money, you know, it's more than the service charge, do you understand?
Okay.
You have your publishing, you have your rights, your performance rights, you have all those things you get. So those things, they happen then because the people, they didn't really know much about it. So it was just like, okay, I just made this big song for this person and it's gone. So, but now it's changing, you know.
It's changing.
Yeah.
You get royalties.
You get royalties.
You get all of that. Like, as a producer in Nigeria now, you can categorically say you're getting your royalties, you're getting your money.
Your
you know,
back.
The split sheet, everything,
you're
is, everything
back.
Is getting ticked.
You're getting
sure?
your back.
Okay, so aside from that,
yeah.
sometimes artists might produce beats for, producers might produce beats for a song, you know, get the artist to record. And I don't know how it works. I am just saying what I'm
saying. Yeah, I'm here. You can ask
okay.
me.
Yeah, very good. And when you produce this beat, you get the artist to record, they do the song. I know sometimes, do you know when it's going to become a hit song when you do the beat? Can you tell?
I think you can tell, but not 100%. So you can say, oh, this song is so nice. This song is going to blow up tomorrow.
So do you always know?
I think so.
So all the artists that you produce
but
for
me,
songs
for me, for me,
song,
I wasn't, for me, I wasn't doing, I don't do songs because this song is going to be a hit song.
It's
I
about,
do
it's
it.
About the artist. They want
yeah.
hit song. Then
I'm telling you, I'm
song.
Telling you, like, I do a feel-good song. Like, okay, this song needs to feel right to me. I need to be connected to this song. If I'm not, bruh.
Wait, when you say you need to be connected to the song, I find that weird because you're not the artist. You're just a producer.
No,
how
I am. I am the. Let me use this. Let me use the word. Permit me, small g. I am the god of the sound. As not the artist.
Wow.
No,
so you're
not.
Saying that regardless
yeah.
of who that artist
yeah.
is,
regardless of
if you produce that beat and an artist comes through and say, oh, I want you to tweak this sound. I want you to tweak this. I don't know how
then
you guys do
that's
it.
What I'm saying. There needs to be a confirmation in my spirit or
okay.
my body or in my brain that
okay.
okay, this if you say you need to tweak this sound, it needs to click here that oh yes
but if I insist that's the one paying because I'm the one paying the piper and I said I want you to tweak it you won't do
no.
it
no there's a way to meet in the middle
okay
you, get, you might tell me am I playing da 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 you want me to play da 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 you get it sounds
okay.
the same da,
okay.
da 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 it's just removing something and joining it
so you decide eventually how that works
at the end of the day
oh I never knew that. Okay, so you produced you've produced a whole lot of hit songs.
Thank
you produced Pana, you produced Tempa,
you
produced Kilo Shele Gong Gong.
Yes.
You've produced like a couple of hit songs.
Yes.
Now, some of those artists that you've produced for in the past, they were really big and they really dropped songs.
Yeah.
And if you look at them in the industry right now, they are not necessarily popping. Now. And you say you're the god of the small god of the sound now. Is there any way I don't want to do this.
Oh no.
Okay. No, don't say no. Please.
I like it.
No. Take for example.
Okay.
Oh God. Liu Kesh.
Okay.
Now, he had major hit songs
okay.
back in the day. You produced
yeah.
some of them,
mm-hmm.
and right now he might not be at the forefront, in the music industry
mm-hmm.
and everything. Is it because you're not producing for him right now? Do you think if Liu Kesh should walk up to you now and come to your studio and say, Krizbeat, give me a beat? And he jumps on that song. Are you saying you can give him a hit song right
See,
now? Can
I'm
you?
Saying, I'm saying anytime, anywhere, anyhow.
Be careful what you say though.
Watch me. Are
okay.
you recording? Please record. Anytime,
uh-huh.
anywhere, anyhow, me and Lil Kesh get into the studio and we do anything, it's going to be a banger.
What?
It's going to be a banger.
So you're saying all Lil Kesh needs to do now is to hear you up?
I'm not saying, okay, maybe he hasn't been doing stuff.
We're not saying that, we're just saying, maybe
he's been doing stuff.
Yeah,
do you understand? But when
back,
me and Liu Kesh
linked up back in the day,
when we come back and do something again,
it's going to be a hit song.
It's going to be a band.
So should I hold you to that one? Okay, Liu Kesh,
you know what?
Listening.
You know what?
Mm-hmm.
I will message him after this thing. And you will see.
Inspired by message. And I will see what's going to come out of that, Abby. Okay, fingers crossed. Okay, let's move on from Liu Kesh now. Now, another question. Sometimes, have you ever been in a situation where you produce beef for an artist and that artist, you know, jumped on it and maybe you didn't know the song was going to be a hit song or someone else to become a hit song and you didn't get paid? Have you do we have situations like that as a producer?
I'm not sure if you know my manager. If you know him, you know.
Leave
it
your
does,
manager.
It does. If you know
Who's
him,
your manager?
You know we don't work like that.
Do you have a manager?
Yeah, his name is Onyami.
Oh, okay. Never heard about him before.
But now you now you
now
are.
I know. I'll check him out.
Yeah,
he works, like, he tries to collect your money. He doesn't play.
He doesn't.
So there is nobody, there is no, you can categorically say that there is no artist in Nigeria right now owing you a dime.
Okay, not physical cash.
Okay.
You get.
So let's call them out.
You call them out.
So do you have artists owing you right now as a producer?
Of course.
What? Like, big names?
Everybody owes now, even...
Even Nigeria? So you have people owing you?
Yeah.
How do you? Okay, so do you want to drop your name? Maybe you can just give it to me. You don't want to drop your name. You don't want to give it. Let me ask you a couple of questions.
Okay.
Let me name some artists. Okay, so have you ever worked with Simi?
Oh, Simi, no.
No, why?
Imagine. No.
No. Okay.
And I love
Simi.
Simi. Yeah.
So maybe we should check that one out.
Yeah.
Okay. I'm talking about artists owing you now. Let me help you with the name since you don't want to do it. Is Lil Kesh owing you?
I don't understand why.
She's not owing you.
Why?
Yes or no?
Are you owing me?
No, you don't do be for me. But you said some people are owing you. So I'm just trying to help you get your money. Is Lil Kesh there?
I'm gonna pass.
Why say? The band. You don't want to tell me.
So, ladies and gentlemen, thank you for tuning in. I go
we
by
are not done.
The drummer boy.
No, we are
by the bar now. We're having fun. We're
not by any bar. You're
so we want to. We're moving to the next song.
No,
we're gonna be playing Tempa.
This is my
remix.
Show. No, we are not playing Tempa remix. I'm still asking you questions. Back to the questions. Since you don't want to answer, you want to help your career. No problem. Let's move on from that. Now, your name, Krizbeat, the drummer boy.
Mm-hmm.
Why drummer boy? How did you come about the name drummer boy? Don't tell me you started in the church.
No,
please.
It didn't.
You didn't start from the church. Where did you
start from? I started from the streets, then I went to the church.
Church is still there.
Yeah, it's there.
Okay, so that's how you came about the drummer boy?
Yeah, I used to beg people to play drums for them, you know. There was this Fuji group.
Okay.
That I used to go beg them to let me play the drums for them.
Okay.
So I was very small, so they don't let me play. Until the person that was supposed to play for a jump didn't come. And they said,
maybe small boy try.
Yeah, but the name Drummer Boy came from the church.
Came from the church. Are you still in the church?
I will always be in the church.
Are you sure? When was the last time you went to church?
Like, day before yesterday.
No, you know it's one thing for you to be in the church, like, to adjust.
No,
the
like,
are you a church boy?
100%.
In every ramification.
Everywhere.
You abide by the Ten Commandments.
No, not the Ten Commandments.
Which one do one out of the ten?
You know, don't let me start preaching here.
That's not the answer. Do you?
You know, it's to abide by the Ten Commandments.
Mm-hmm.
You need grace. You get,
need
and
grace.
That's why Jesus Christ came into the picture.
Okay.
Do you understand? And if you look into the.
Wow, wow. So you still sin, basically. That's what you're trying to say. Okay.
I mean, don't we all do?
Don't put me in that, please. Speak for yourself. So in Nigeria, when we talk about some, when we list some producers,
mm-hmm.
we automatically think about some artists because
mm-hmm.
they work with those artists.
Yeah.
Now, if you talk about Sars, you talk about Whiskey, you think Whiskey, you think Niola, we talk mm-hmm. about everything with DMW. Do you have any artists right now that, because I know in the past you've not really focused on one artist,
mm-hmm.
do you have plans to do that?
Oh, we have I'm sure you guys know C-Boy.
Okay.
Yeah, C-Boy. I've been working on this project hand in hand, and you know, been trying to get stuff out. He has a new song out, by the way. Put it. And do you
that's
have
jam.
It?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Jam.
So
okay, so that's C-Boy. Okay.
And we have like a couple of people that you guys will know soon. We'll be introducing more guys to you.
That's why you're here. This is an interview, so give me exclusive.
No names yet, but they
will
come. It could be you, you know.
No.
You don't want to sing she. If you are in the studio now and I give you a beat, you know.
So when I drive by and I turn my car and I run in the car and I move around and my name is the melody. I think you can make it song.
I'm telling you.
Wow, my career is about to kick off. This is nice. I've got talent.
I'll give you a hit song.
Not that one. So join the conversation. Please call me up 0700-1051-1051. I've got Krizbeat in the studio. So when you produce Fana, I read about that one. You spoke about it in an interview, and you said that techno, that song or that beat wasn't meant for Tekno. It was meant for some other artist, and the artist turned it down, and they had to give it to Tekno. Who is that artist?
You don't know him.
What's the name of the artist? I'll Google it.
I put,
you don't know him for it.
Just say the name, it doesn't even matter.
It's
say
not even, it's not even an English name.
Say it. Ah, God. I said they don't want to give us a clue. Can you give someone a beat for free?
I can give you.
Not the beat that you used and remain, like free beat. You give a free beat.
It depends if the person has a free talent.
Wow, that is so low. Okay, so I read somewhere that you've worked with a couple of foreign artists.
I read well.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so how did that one happen? Give us names.
Oh, we have, I've done Ty Dolla $ign, I've done Ashanti, I've done...
Brag about it. Now you're ready, you're licking your lips. When I asked you for a name, you didn't drop Ashanti. Name of the people owing you, you didn't say. Now I've done Ashanti, I've done Ty Dolla. Continue. Let's hear
you. We're currently working with Drake.
You're working with Drake?
Yes, sir.
Now?
Yes.
For what? How?
Don't put her in my mouth.
What? This one, I'll open your mouth.
Okay, let me bust your head. There's a Nigerian song produced by me.
Okay.
That features Rihanna coming soon.
Wait.
No artist. Wait. I'm telling you the artist.
You wish. I think I'll stop there. You really wish. So you have a new song that is dropping that you produced that has Rihanna on it and a Nigerian artist.
Yeah.
Who is Nigerian artist?
International
Badman. That's Runtown now.
I don't know. Who sang that one?
International Badman Killer Runtown.
Ah, I love that song.
That's not the point. That's not the point. Is it Runtown?
No. It's Run City.
What is the name of it? Okay, so we should.
I'll tell you.
You tell me. Okay.
Yeah.
Are you sure?
Mm-hmm.
Are you sure? Okay, I'll hold you to that one. So you've worked with Ty Dolla $ign in the past.
Yeah.
What song?
Ty Dolla $ign. No, I've worked with Ty Dolla $ign. The song is not out.
Okay.
It's going to be Krizbeat, Somebody and Ty.
Are these your songs or?
No, this one, I'm featured on the song and I produced it.
For Ty Dolla $ign.
No,
for
the
artist who featured Ty Dolla $ign.
And Chris,
that's a
1990s,
I'm sure.
Yes,
so
right.
talk about Ashanti.
Yeah, we did Ashanti. That's EXO, Asha, with features Ashanti, Early in the Morning. Yeah, and which other song again? Okay, we African Beauty. Yeah, Omarion and Diamond Platnumz.
I know that song.
Yes,
you produced it.
Yes, I did.
Wow. You're getting paid in dollars, man. And I remember you said you're single. That's good.
Okay.
Don't worry. I'm just, you know, picturing things in my head. I can't that one come.
Like you're picturing like white dress, agbada,
beautiful children,
yeah,
flowers, sunsets.
Everywhere.
Yeah. Okay. So, how did you hook up with Omari?
Oh, it was in SA. We went for ADM tour.
Okay.
In SA.
ADM tour.
ADM. That's the name of my first album.
Okay.
Afro dance music.
Okay.
So they met with my manager in the lobby actually. So they told
it's
us if we came with Diamond.
Can I manage you instead?
No. He met with Diamond.
Wow.
But you can manage other things.
I want to manage your talent. That one has money. I don't think
you're right. Do you know who I am?
That's what I want to manage your talent. That's
if I speed
thing.
Here is talent.
So Omari met with your manager.
So yeah, they asked if we came to SA with studio. We didn't come with studio, so immediately he went to like a music store close by to get the equipment.
Immediately.
I'm telling you.
You hear money.
It's
money currency. You make things happen.
So he in the room that day, I made the beat and played it for him.
And he loved it,
and we just did it.
You got paid. More.
Do I look like I don't get paid?
No, you don't look like actually. You look like you get paid a lot. So, aside from your song, the one you just dropped, Amina, and also the collaborative album you dropped with C-Boy, what else are you doing in 2019?
Okay, yeah. The album for 2019 is ready, to be honest with
you.
We have, like, amazing artists on it. Don't worry, this one I'll tell you.
I'm gonna ask C-Boy.
We have Wiz, we have Techno, we have Timaya, we have Diamond Platinums, we have Rayvanny, we have C Boy, we have Amin, we have Great Melody, we have.
I can do something for you. Like, just give me a line.
We have a hook. We have like other African
artists. When are you dropping?
We have Tenny. Yes, we have Tenny. The song with Tenny is.
Oh, when are you dropping it?
I feel like that should be a single.
I think so. Maybe we should drop that one before the album. You see,
let me manage you. If I say yes now, you say hey, you want to get royalty for no. Why not drop it?
Let me tell you something. I've got amazing talent. I've got amazing proposal for you. That.
What do you do?
Don't worry. I can help you. Forget.
Are you a helper?
Okay. So when are you gonna drop that album?
I think a few days to my birthday.
When is your birthday?
December.
Long time, so we have to wait that.
Yeah,
long,
so we have to give you some time before then.
Okay, so you'll be dropping single before you drop the album?
To be honest, I just want to drop the album because we're like planning to compile videos and just put it in your face.
Okay. So the album, you've got something coming up with Rihanna, you've got something coming up with Ty Dolla $ign that we should look forward to.
DJ Khaled?
Yeah. You've got something coming with DJ Khaled? DJ Khaled, Rihanna, Ty Dolla $ign,
Drake,
Ashanti.
Yes.
Ah. Who else?
And I want Asha for this album.
You want Asha? Okay.
Drake. Can you hook me up?
You mentioned Drake somewhere. So
can you hook me up?
With Asha. Yeah. If you sack your manager and employ me, I'll do that. So, okay. You mentioned Drake. Uh-huh. Do you have Drake on your album too? Or do you have
Not on the album. We have something coming up on other.
Which Drake too.
Yeah,
wow. 2019 is going to be really hot for you as a producer.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Thank you so much, Krizbeat, for coming through. Please, before you drop the album, you can come back again in preparation of the album. Or after you drop the album, I'll talk about it. Mm-hmm. That time I'll be your manager already. Right? Mm-hmm. Okay. Thank you so much.
I manage things.
I'll manage you and your talent.
Who says it's not me?
Krizbeat, C-Boy, Rivani, Young Says, Put It, Play Next, or Season 105. It's your Hanging with Melody, and this is City Cafe.
We got the hits. We got the gist. This is Lagos' number one lifestyle station, City 105.1 FM.